About 6 months ago, I decided to build my own 8x10 camera. I already have one, a DV 8x10, and I bought it probably 10 to 15 years ago. And it's not really good. I only bought it because it was very cheap. It's a studio camera on the rail, and it's heavy to the point that the only few times I had to move it anywhere to shoot anything, by the time I got there, I was already tired and just ready to get it done and just to go home. With a heavy camera, you end up with like a heavy tripod, and both of them with the rest of the gear, it's just a pain to move around. I started to draw the camera on the computer about 6 months ago, and I wanted to make it more like a field camera, mainly because of the way they look, but also they are like easier to pack. And at the time, I quickly realized I would need to build it basically at the same time that I was drawing it. There's just too many things to fit in like a tight space. And I saw that drawing all of it first would not translate into a really usable product. Quite often I 3D printed a bracket or like a small adjustment hand wheel and realized that it wasn't the right size or it was awkward to use. So at first I wanted to make it out of wood, but after thinking about it, I realized that most likely I would not really get a good result. There's like too much going on with all the movements to pack in like a small box, and most likely as I build it, I probably have to do a lot of rework. Just too much rework. So I decided to use like a modular approach and use aluminum extrusion, like 15 by 15 as you can see here. And that worked really well. If something didn't fit, and it was quite often, you know, there's just a lot of interference all over the place. Like when you fold this, or, you know, when you close it, you know, I could just change the sizes in minutes and just kind of readjust. So the camera's based on a 300 millimeter by 300 meter square frame. I made the front extension on a rectangular frame. And the back extension on a U-shaped frame. And I'm using like belt for 3D printers to move them forward and back. Like the front frame move with the front hand wheel and like two belts, one on each side. And the back frame moves on the back hand wheel, and also like two belts, and they get locked with like this, like just kind of simple locking system. That's just enough. So underneath, I used anti-friction tape to make the extrusion slide against each other more easily, and they are held together with like I don't know if you can see it, but like T-nuts there. And like 3D printed pin as well to make them glide straight and secure. And it's surprisingly rigid. So the bellows extend to 690 millimeter, all extended. Okay, extend that a bit further. So with that, you can use 650 millimeter lens with movements. You know, that kind of gives a good good enough range. I've made some 45 degree cuts on the joint, on the front and the back standard, but that's not really needed. It was just like from the previous design. It's not really easy to make and to get them exact same size and align them with the connectors, because the connectors are not really 90 degrees. So if I had to do it again, I would make the connection square, but still 45 degrees kind of look better. So I'm okay with that. So the front standard can rise by 65 millimeter and drop by like 55 millimeter, and I can also tilt it by 20 degrees front and back. I need to redo those pieces out of aluminium. So the rotation from the bottom plate is 15 degrees each way, and the rotation point is just below where the aperture ring would be on a copper shutter, so it would stay in focus more easily. The lens board is thinner, by the way, and you can tilt like, you know, the entire thing as much as you want if you use this. So the back standard use those two, I don't know if you can see that well. So those two there are used for the rotation. I about 7.5 degrees each way. And with those, you can like side shift by by 30 millimeter each way. And the entire back standard can rise with this by 50 millimeter. And also you have the shift front and back. So quite a lot of movement. The thing I like the most about this camera is that it's completely modular. If I have a movement that I never use, I can just save weight and I can just remove it. If I only have like a 300 millimeter, I can just remove the entire like back extension or front extension and change the standard and shrink the entire camera. I made the bellows from some lightproof cloth that I bought online. It's sold as lightproof curtains. It's very thin. It's like 0.1 millimeter. The fabric, and I used two layers to be sure that it was light tight, and some cardboard ribs of 0.4 millimeter. If I had to do it again, I would probably change the geometry of the bellow and make them a bit thinner when compressed. I could have probably saved about 10 millimeter overall when the camera's closed. If I had to do the entire camera again, I would probably just buy the bellows already made with the shape that I like, and just make the camera around the bellows, and that would save a lot of time. Like making the bellow is just not really fun, and it's just too much work, and especially too much work to set up. The cloth that I bought to make the bellows was packed very tightly in a small like rectangular shape, and it left a pattern of like folds, and it was really difficult to make them disappear. And some are like still visible, like I don't know if you can see this this line there and other places. Overall, I'm very happy with the camera. When I started, I didn't know what the end product would look and feel like. And sometimes you can end up like with something where the overall quality or usability is not really there. And it's not the case here. With this camera, it just works, and I can see myself using it for like many years to come.